Military leaders and elected officials gathered with friends and family to mourn former Missouri Congressman Ike Skelton today. Skelton died a week ago of complications from pneumonia. Skelton served as chairman of the House Armed Services Committee and is widely credited with helping build up Missouri's military installations of Fort Leonard Wood and Whiteman Air Force Base. Skelton battled polio his entire life. He had limited use of one arm and no use of the other. But Skelton almost never brought the subject up. Tonight, KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney has an exclusive look at a rare interview where Skelton talks candidly about it.
In November of 1947, 15-year-old Wentworth Academy cadet Ike Skelton came back from a band trip and collapsed at home.
Then I thought it was just a very, very bad cold. And it turned out to be more than that.
Back then, polio was a mysterious and sometimes fatal disease. But his dad was able to get him to the Polio Foundation in Warm Springs, Georgia, the same place where President Franklin Roosevelt had used for his polio treatments.
He was there for two reasons. One reason was to rehabilitate what muscles that you had and to teach you to use them. In my case, how to put on a shirt and tie a tie, for instance.
Self-reliance. Now, when he returned to Lexington, his classmates urged young Skelton to go back out for track. They found some track shorts with pockets, cut holes in them, and then taped his dangling arms to his legs. He finished third. Today, senators and members of Congress joined the folks of a little Missouri town in a show of respect for a self-reliant man who made it into the big leagues of politics.
Warm Springs, Georgia, whatever their magic was, it worked.
Skelton didn't talk much about his polio, but he seemed to turn it around and use it as a source of strength. Michael Mahoney, KMBC 9 News, Lexington, Missouri.